Hi guys, I hope you're having a good day, because today we have good news, whether you're an AMD or an Nvidia owner. And that is AMD's FSR, or Fidelity FX Super Resolution, their long-awaited response to DLSS. As you're probably aware, Nvidia DLSS has been probably the best feature of their latest GPUs, allowing for significant performance gains in compatible titles, and something AMD had no answer to until now. DLSS is a closed-box proprietary NVIDIA system, so we don't know exactly how it works, but the basics are that a developer sends very high-res images of their game, probably around 16K, to NVIDIA, who use these to train their AI to reproduce the same images from a much, much lower resolution source image, 720p for example, and the results speak for themselves. However, the downside of this is that it is a long process that the developer has no control over. And while we don't know exactly what NVIDIA charged to do this, it isn't cheap. In addition, the process only works for customers with Turing or Ampere GPUs, the RTX 20 and 30 series respectively. AMD's FSR works differently. Instead of a complex proprietary system involving specific hardware, it is simply an additional step in the existing graphics pipeline. And even better than that, one they're going to be making open source, so all developers can make use of it. Those less familiar with how 3D graphics works, here's an example using Blender, which is different to games, but will help visualize what happens. First, the basic image is rendered, then additional effects are applied on top, in this case bloom, but in the case of FSR, it's upscaling and sharpening. No fancy tensor cores needed, and no time spent training AI. This means unlike DLSS, AMD can offer it not only to the latest 6000 series of cards, but all the way back to 2016's RX 400 series, and as low as the RX 460. It even works on NVIDIA GPUs. So let's take a look at how it functions on an RTX 3070. Much like the DLSS launch, FSR on day one was only available on a small range of titles. So I've selected two of these to take a look at, starting with Anno 1800 and later the AMD-sponsored Godfall. So here we have Anno 1800 at 4K with all settings maxed out, starting with native on the left and then ultra, quality, balance, and performance setting on the right. And I think it's fair to say the results here are quite impressive. First of all, that it even works on an NVIDIA GPU, but also that it works well. Each setting provides a good boost to frame rates and without any significant loss of image quality compared to the former. Ultra quality is almost 40% higher FPS than native, and I really cannot see the difference in image quality. And performance mode more than doubles the frame rate, although there is some trade-offs in image here. If we take a closer look at just the quality and performance modes, we can see that the native and quality modes are practically the same here. In fact, I think I personally prefer the look of the quality mode over native for some reason. But the performance mode is losing detail on the cobbles, and especially around the marketplace edges. It's not major, but it is slightly different. That said, performance mode is at least double the frame rate. And if we take a closer look, it's using around 1.4 gigabytes less VRAM, around a 25% reduction, due to it being a lower resolution image that's upscaled. It does have higher CPU usage, around 7% more on my now getting old 6700K. There could be situations where that's significant. In my personal opinion though, performance mode and its DLSS counterpart should be ignored, and instead you should just lower settings and stick with either ultra or quality mode, both of which provide what is essentially free frame rate and a slight reduction in VRAM, with CPU usage so similar it really won't ever be significant. So late on in my testing, I switched to DirectX 11. The game says DirectX 12 is faster, and there is no reason for it to make any difference to FSR, but I just thought I'd try it out anyway. I've checked and double checked these results, but DirectX 11 frame rates are 10% higher approximately than those for DirectX 12, which is of course the opposite to what you would expect. I presume this has something to do with the NVIDIA driver overhead being so high on older CPUs like mine. However, as I don't have a faster CPU to test this with, I cannot be 100% sure. It isn't FSR because I get the same result even with the FSR disabled. But yeah, it's something to be aware of. That zoomed in scene isn't the most representative of Anno 1800 gameplay, and on the 3070 I'd ignore 4K and instead opt for 1440p with Ultra FSR. And the reason for that is, as the game progresses and you start zooming around the map, frame rates suffer quite a bit without performance modes, and in motion, performance mode gives an unpleasant amount of blur. Not unlike DLSS on its performance setting, it should be noted. but this is better demonstrated in our other FSR title, God Awful. Godful. First off, the static scene performance. We don't even need to look closely to see the visual difference between off and performance. Most notable areas are the smoke, which steps down in appearance significantly, and this moving star thingy, which goes from basketball image without FSR to oddly fuzzy on the performance setting. The performance difference, though, is incredible, going from 50fps to 125fps while using about 1.3GB less VRAM, 1GB less system RAM. There is a big step up in CPU usage, however, going from around 16% to 35%. Not too critical in the scene, but there could definitely be times when more than doubling CPU usage is an issue. Again, quality mode stands out here. The drop in image fidelity is barely noticeable, even when looking closely. But 1.8x in frame rate from 50 to 90fps using almost 1GB less VRAM and half a gig less system memory is quite impressive. However, Godfall is not a standstill looking at details kind of game, so let's see this in motion. So we have here native versus performance, and this is not my type of game, so it's not matched up too well, but you get the idea. This is FSR at its worst. Everything in this shot is a blurry mess, like someone has taken a depth of field slider and set the focal point to inside your left nostril. All the detail is removed, and for about 60% extra frame rate, costing 300% CPU usage. That said, DLSS 2.0 on its maximum performance setting does much the same thing, and DLSS 1.0, which is what this launched implementation should really be compared to, was a bit like this on any setting. AMD really deserves some credit here. Their upscaling is similar to DLSS 2.0, but without the need for specific hardware and supporting cards going all the way back to the RX 460 and GeForce 10 series. It really is noteworthy. It may have only launched on 7 titles initially, but that's still better than DLSS managed at first, and it's still much easier and cheaper for developers to enable. There really isn't any reason why FSR can't become an industry standard this generation, and even on consoles. It's got wide hardware support and delivers decent, sometimes even great results, so it should be a win for gamers, and well, I always like that. Will it be a win for AMD though, is another matter. For enthusiast level customers, the kind that watch tech related YouTube content for example, will know about it, and will also know that buying an Nvidia GPU gets you this and DLSS 2.0, whereas the less well informed user probably doesn't even know it exists. However, they probably have heard of the Nvidia exclusive magic of DLSS, as it has been out for a while and it has received a fairly high amount of praise by the more informed customer base. DLSS 2.0 at any rate. I do think it's probably the right strategy for AMD, as having a lockdown DLSS style system and almost no market share doesn't actually get them anything. But if this does become an industry standard, it at least removes Nvidia's big hit at DLSS from the conversation. Mostly, anyway. I know, speaking personally, DLSS just went from a killer feature to a nice to have feature, and one that I can easily see not caring about the next time I'm in the market to buy a GPU. Assuming FSR becomes widely adopted, of course. And even if FSR doesn't help move the industry away from proprietary systems like DLSS towards more open and available systems that benefit all gamers, making this video has at least introduced me to Anno 1800, which I really enjoyed. And if you enjoyed this video or found it informative, why not hit that like button to help others see it, and I'll see you next time. Take care of yourself.